responses. The second wave isn't just starting. It's already underway.
COVID-19 is back in full force in Canada. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau raised this alarm as he warned that this second wave could be worse than what Canadians experienced last spring. Canada's public health chief, Dr. Theresa Tam, recently projected that Canada's numbers could increase by more than 5,000 cases by next Friday. The total number of confirmed coronavirus cases in Canada is close to 150,000, with the bulk of the infections found in Quebec. Trudeau called on Canadians to work together to get through this second wave.
But what we can change is where we are in October and into the winter. It's all too likely we won't be gathering for Thanksgiving, but we still have a shot at Christmas. Together, we have the power to get the second wave under control.
Quebec, which has the highest number of cases in Canada, agreed that people should rethink their Thanksgiving plans on October 12.
I would prefer canceling a lot of those in the next few weeks to make sure that we have a nice Christmas.
But Alberta said there is as yet no second wave in their province, and its health chief said up to 15 people can still gather on Thanksgiving.
It's best to keep gatherings within your established cohorts of up to 15 people outside your household. Smaller is safer. This is not the time for large gatherings.
Meanwhile, despite growing calls for rapid testing, Deputy Prime Minister Chrystia Freeland stressed Canada will not interfere in the work of regulators as other governments have done.
We are seeing interference and pressure on regulators around the world, and I think we can all see the very dangerous consequences of that kind of an approach.
Following Wednesday's throne speech, Freeland and Economic Minister Carla Qualtro unveiled the proposed Canada Recovery Benefits Act to continue helping jobless Canadians through the second wave until 2021.
The Canada Recovery Benefit will help Canadians who stopped working due to COVID-19 but do not qualify for EI, and Canadians who continue to have their employment or self-employment income reduced by 50% or more due to COVID-19. It would provide eligible workers with $500 per week for up to 26 weeks between September 27, 2020 and September 25, 2021.
Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News.
Politics to gain some support from the opposition parties to get this done quickly, and two, at the same time, what is the message that you provide to Canadians who need these benefits?